So what type of response do you get after you cut the majority of trees in an area? Well, that's what we're gonna talk about this week on LandBeat. Well, we're back here at my farm in northern Pennsylvania. We filmed on this a couple of years ago. This was solid woods through here. We came in and cut almost every overstory tree so we could get this response from the seed bank. We wanted more herbaceous material here, and we want something that provides much better cover and food for deer. As you can see behind me, we have this wall of vegetation. There are deer trails through here. Deer are using this like crazy. So did we get the response we wanted? We certainly are getting the response we want from deer. They are in here all the time. Provide great stand setups. We're providing food and cover at ground level. So things are very good. Well, not entirely. Yes, deer are using this. We got the response from the vegetation we want, but in this case, we got a lot of autumn olive that has come back. Autumn olive is very invasive, and it takes over many of these areas. Birds like the berries, raccoons like the berries, a lot of species. So they share the berries around. Very easy to spread autumn olive to places that you don't want. It can take over large areas, and as you can see here, it is dominating this part of the site. So it is good cover. It does provide some food. It's not the best thing for the area, though. I would rather have the same type of vegetative response, but from something, a more native species, and something that's a little more wildlife friendly and doesn't take over everything. So some people get so concerned, like, I'm not gonna cut trees because I'm afraid I'll get something bad. And I look at it like this. In many cases, when you cut, you get something good. In this case, I wish this wasn't all autumn olive. So what are we gonna do? We're gonna kill this. This isn't the end of the world by any means. We can come in and literally cut some of these down. That's a lot of work. Easier is we can come in and just literally spray these and kill them. We'll get the response from something else in the seed bank. The easiest way though to get rid of this is to run a fire through here during the late part of the growing season, so toward the end of the summer. If we burn this in the dormant season, it will top kill a lot of this, but it'll come right back. So what I'm gonna do is we'll have a fire break around the outside of this patch. Literally we'll run a fire through here late this summer. And what that means is all the reserves, or almost all the reserves, are out of the roots. They're in these leaves. So if we burn this at that time of the year, there's nothing left for this to come back next year. We will absolutely kill this. And then we'll get another response from what's in the seed bank. If it's some more of this, hey, we can kill part of that. But every time we do this, it's just gonna continue to get better and better with the absolute species that we want, and certainly provide tremendous cover, tremendous food, and then, hey, tremendous hunting opportunities for us come this fall. Well, this is where I stood 2 years ago. Following the winter that we had cut this, when this was all still wide open. And you can see the response. We have all kinds of herbaceous stuff here. We have forbs in here feeding you. Look at all the flowering stuff. We have black-eyed Susans, wild bergamot. We have yarrow, Queen Anne's lace, and more. So all kinds of stuff for deer, for turkeys, for songbirds, for other wildlife. We also now are getting clumps of some woody stuff, which deer love to be in and around all that. So the response we have, it's blocking visually. Deer are gonna feel comfortable moving through here. We have more food. We have higher quality food than we had underneath that forest. And we absolutely have increased the number of stand setups that we have on this part of the property. So this has been a win-win all the way around for deer, numerous other wildlife species, and certainly us as the hunters. So you can take a look at what we have here. Certainly good from a deer end. And some folks say, well, yeah, you know, I don't have 5 months to do this. And I'll tell you, this literally, this project was myself, my two kids, and my best friend. My hunting buddy right here, there was four of us that spent a weekend doing this, and not even all day on Saturday and all day on Sunday. So very doable for anybody. We have a few acres here that have been treated. You know, if we had another weekend, we certainly can add on to that. The point is, do what you can, spend a few hours, spend a weekend if you can, and so you get this tremendous response for deer. So the way to have a better hunting this fall is to spend every hour that you can during the year getting ready for that, for this. And every hour that you put in, this continues to build the response that you get and just continues to make it better. And this is certainly doable by anybody anywhere across the Whitetails Range.